damage or something?
No, no, it's okay.
So, hallo, schönen guten Nachmittag. Es hallt noch sehr laut. Zu diesem Mediengespräch von Borussia Dortmund. Ich freue mich, dass wir wieder Pressekonferenzen, Mediengespräche machen können mit Journalisten anwesend. Und wir haben heute einen unserer neuen Spieler mitgebracht, Thomas Meunier. Die Pressekonferenz auf Französisch zu machen war keine Option. Deswegen werden wir dann aber ins Englische überswitchen als gemeinsame Nenner. Und Thomas, first of all, welcome.
Thank you very much.
To this brand new media center. I think you're the first player who is doing a press conference. And I would say ready for the questions of the journalists. Sebastian Wessling, Funke Medien.
Well, maybe first of all, to start us off, how have the first days been here in Dortmund?
They've been really good, really, really well. I have to say, on and off the pitch, really all the people, the players and the the people working around the team and in the team are really kind with me. It's always a positive talk. We have a really good group, and really I didn't need 4 hours to feel that something new and really positive was welcoming me. So it's been at the moment 10 days really positive.
Thomas Hennecke, Kicker.
Even a number 9.
A number 9?
Yeah.
Okay. So you are actually a defender who prefers to attack?
A long time ago, I could decide what I wanted to do on the pitch. But since I'm professional, I cannot decide anymore. So I can adapt myself, really. I take the example last year with Tuchel in Paris. The focus was really on the 4 main players, you know, in the front. And it's like, recover the ball, give them, they will make the difference. So I was much more defensive. It was not a problem because we won many games and they did the job, we did our job, and it was a good thing, good balance. But of course, like when we play with the national team, we play with 3 defenders, I'm like a wing back. And I like to give some assist and to score some goals, because the real pleasure is to get the, you know, that feeling of cheering with the stadium and to score a goal. There is nothing comparable, and but I can adapt. It's not really a question.
Patrick Berger für Sport 1.
Hallo. I think that just we just have to adapt also. We have to see the opponent. Playing with 3 behind when you play against Bayern or Leipzig, it's always something dangerous. You can do it, but it's dangerous. I'm used to play for a few years in club as a 4-3-3. But depends also the players that you have, you know. If you have a lot of players that defends, or you have a lot of that likes to attack, you need like good midfielder, depends the quality that you have in your team. Of course, if I have to choose, I just want to play an offensive football. So even with 4 behind, you can play with a high block, and make the difference, you know, like a high pressure directly on the opponent when they try to build up. Just something to work during the training, but no, I don't have any preference.
Als kleinen Reminder zwischendurch, wenn ihr dran seid mit den Fragen, einmal aufs Knöpfchen vor euch drücken und dann sollte das Mikrofon eigentlich angehen. Sebastian Wessling hatte die nächste Frage gestellt, danach Olli Müller.
Again a question in a similar direction. The position you would prefer to play when you play with the back three, would it be the right wing or do you also maybe see yourself as a right center back, because at least the physics you have them to be a little more defensive. What would you say?
It wouldn't be for the team if I play behind. It wouldn't be good, I think, because I always want to go forward. And so there would be a hole in the defense, and it would be a problem. I think the players would always to cover me, and I will stay an offensive player. You know, I can defend and stay behind, but we were four, and being like right central defender, it's not something for me, not at the moment. I still have the power and the way to attack.
Okay, Olli Müller für Die Welt.
Hello.
Hello.
Before you took the decision to come to Dortmund, what were the priorities you put up for yourself, what you want to achieve in Dortmund, and just in general, if you could tell what are the main reasons to come to Dortmund, different situations from PSG, they're number one in France. Here we have the big FC Bayern as a number one. What do you think you want to achieve in the next years?
Everywhere I've been to, I played with ambition, and in Club Brugge we won the cup, the championship, with Paris Cup championship. If I choose for Dortmund, it's because I know we can win cup and championship. Okay, sometimes it takes time, and there is Bayern, as you say, but in comparison with France, you know, it's totally different. It's not better or worse. Like in France, you have Paris, but the difference between Paris and the other clubs is too big, and that's the problem. Because you know, they have more money, more power, better player. It's difficult for a team like Lyon or Marseille if you don't get players, you know, that cost 50 million. You cannot win against Paris, to make it simple. But here in Germany it's totally different, and you have clubs like, you know, you have Bayern, you have Dortmund, you have Leipzig, Leverkusen, like Schalke is still also a good club, and a few other ones like Mönchengladbach, for example, who can make the difference, who can really fight for the top three or even the title until the end of the season. And that's the difference with the French competition.
Dann gehen wir einmal nach hinten aufs TV-Podium. Harald Grundmann von der ARD.
Over the here.
Yeah, hello.
Hi. Did you talk to Axel before you signed up in Dortmund? And what did he tell you about the club and about the town Dortmund, about everything here?
I talked to him just before my signing, but he talked to me because he heard a lot of noise about me in the club, and I confirmed him, yeah, that was true. And he was, I think, the first one wanted me to come, and it was also the same feeling for me. So it was just a positive talk about the club, about the objective, about the ambition, and sure, he didn't have to convince me to come, because in my head it was already, my choice was done. But it was, yeah, I spoke a little bit with Axel, also with a few people from the club in Paris, because yeah, they know, they were here, so. But it was always positive, and it just, you know, like I felt that I made the good choice when I spoke with them.
Thomas Hennecke nochmal vom Kicker und danach Matthias, du.
Jetzt geht's. Thomas, you had the opportunity to feel the special atmosphere in Dortmund in February when you played with Paris here. Did this influence your decision in any way to come to Dortmund?
I had already signed before that game, so it just also come. I had goosebumps during the Champions League item. You know, everybody screaming. It was the first time for me that I had to play in such a stadium with such an atmosphere. You know, it was really special. The atmosphere was also nice in Paris for the Champions League game, but like all the stadium is, you know, and there are many more people in the stadium, and it was like, I will be there next year. I will feel that again. I hope so. With Corona, I know it's a bit difficult at that moment, but it's typically what I'm playing football for, you know. And I'm still popular really in my head, you know, like I told a few times. Dortmund is like Club Brugge. It's the evolved version of Brugge. It's like really popular, city of workers, a lot of fun everywhere in the country. And it's their life, you know, and that's what I like. It's authentic, it's a realness, and I was looking for something like this.
Dann kommen wir zu Matthias Scherf, Radio 91.2.
Was a little bit a question in the same direction, but you said Dortmund is a city of workers. Does it fit to your style of playing, or how would you describe your style of playing? Are you also a typical hard-working football player?
I think so. Well, you will judge during the season, but it's not like I'm not a super talented player. But I think that if I made it as a professional football player, that's also because I work hard. And even when I was 18, you know, I signed to Bruges. They wanted to rent me to another a small club. But because I worked so hard, you know, and I came from the amateur football, it was like, no, you stay with us, you will play. And in Paris, it was the same. You know, it's like, I never complain, even if I don't like something, you know, I just do, and it's also part of the job, you know, and but I think you will judge, I never give up, and for me, you know, that's important to have that working mentality.
Thomas hatte nochmal eine Frage.
Champions League will continue in these days, Thomas. Do you feel any kind of sadness that you cannot participate and finish the Paris campaign?
No, it's a bit, you know, from the past, but of course I wanted to finish the competition. No, I'm a competitor, and I did everything with Paris in Champions League. I played every game, just the last one against Dortmund. I was suspended, but otherwise, you know, and we had also, and we have, and they have a really good team in Paris, and the actual like situation is really positive for Paris, like a one leg game with the players that we have in the team. It's just like wonderful. Paris has a really great opportunity to win the Champions League, and of course, yeah. No, I mean Dortmund. It's, you know, it's done, but my first wish was to finish the competition. You know, the two cups also, and the Champions League with Paris.
Ich würde sagen, wir machen drei Fragen. Fangen an mit Sebastian Wessling.
More experienced now. How would you see your role in this group?
You didn't dare to say oldest.
I'm only 28.
I'm only 28. Don't worry. Yeah, experience. I like the word because I've been in a few clubs, and I've seen many different way of working. I like to have that like big brother role. There are a few really good players training with us at the moment, and if we can like surrounding them, you know, I think they can improve. Like for example, Youssoufa Moukoko is a really really good player. You see it directly. and we can help them to improve their football and to increase also their, you know, their motivation and their will to perform. I think we have like players as Piszczek, Hummels, Schuss, Axel. We have a few good players. They have experience and they can really help the young one.
Die vorletzte Frage von Olli Müller und den Abschluss macht dann noch Patrick Berger.
At the end of the season, you obviously had some quarrels with PSG, with Leonardo. I think everything is said about this, but I wonder, because in these times it appears to me as unusual that the player himself makes his point and says clearly what he doesn't like and where he thinks he has been treated wrong. Usually the players let their agents talk. Are you someone who always says very, very straight and clear when he doesn't like something?
I like honest people. And it's not because you are in a better position than most of the people that you can speak saying, you know, lie, that you can lie. And that was the case with Leonardo. That's what I really wanted, to make the things clear. Because, you know, Paris in France, it's so powerful that even the media didn't always dare to say something bad about the club. And that's the problem. So if you don't defend yourself, you will never get it right. And when, for example, he told that I didn't want to resign with them for the Champions League, it was not true, because I was the first one asking that. And so I just had to make the things clear, you know, for everybody, not to think that I don't care about Paris, so I don't care about my teammates, because it's not true.
Die letzte Frage, Patrick Berger, Sport 1.
Thomas, we already spoke about your aims and goals here in Dortmund, and about titles. It's a big desire here in Dortmund of winning titles again. The last is, I think, 2017. What makes you so confident to reach it during your time here in Dortmund?
Because I watch a lot of games of Dortmund last season. The second round was particularly positive and good. And also, like, being in the position of an outsider, you know, when you have Bayern in front of you, it's always, for me, the best position. Because you're chasing and you can... probably you have more opportunity to decide what you want to do or not when you are chasing, you know. And with the quality that the group have, I hope everybody will stay. We can really, really improve our game and win something, even this year already. That's my ambition. Of course, you can not always predict the future, but yeah. We have everything in hand, anyway.
We call it Challenger.
Exactly.
Okay, danke euch für die Fragen. Thank you, Thomas. Merci.
Willkommen.
Und dann sehen wir uns bald in Bad Ragaz wahrscheinlich schon.
Willkommen.